no one's ever heard of. St. Paul has a way to trade Midway Stadium, that is the current home of the St. Paul Saints. In return, they will get this land in Lower Town with the hope the team will get a new stadium there. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Jenny Griswold is live in Lower Town tonight to explain how this whole thing's going to work. Jenny?
Bill, the Port Authority has an agreement to buy this land. This is the old Gillette building by the farmers market. Now, the next step would be the Port Authority and the City of St. Paul swapping locations. The Saints would build a ballpark here, and the Port Authority would get the old Midway Stadium land.
You know, it's 30 years old, and we have pounded it. Our fans have pounded it for 20 years now.
The St. Paul Saints say they're ready to play ball somewhere else. The Port Authority says the Midway Stadium land is perfect for them.
To take down the old stadium, clean up the contamination that's there, do soil correction work, geotech work that's there, and then sell that property for industrial development.
The city and team would chip in $27 million to build the new Saints Ballpark in Lower Town. The remaining $27 million would come from a Department of Employment and Economic Development grant. The mayor applied for the grant this week, but still doesn't have the money. We asked if this land swap is putting the cart before the horse.
It's going to be a competitive situation, and you know, we take nothing for granted. So we're going to have to do really well with our application.
But in any development deal, someone has to go first.
And they said they made the first move because this economic development grant is all about creating jobs. They say by having the land in hand, they show they are ready to start construction, which of course leads to jobs. Live in St. Paul, Jennifer Griswold, 5 Eyewitness News.